So let's say you have a video, and here's a very simple example. The video just has some things that happen in it, and you want to put some music to it, but you want to have certain sound effects occur at times like that when there's a transition. I just made this very simple video in Keynote. So you can see I want to have the sound effects timed perfectly in the soundtrack to fit the events happening in there. So you can do this in GarageBand using a little known feature. So in GarageBand, we'll create an empty project here, and I'll just use the software instrument as the basis there. And I'm going to want to time the music and sound effects to the video. So one way I can do that is to bring the video into GarageBand. A lot of people don't know you can bring video into GarageBand. I'm going to drag the video file here into GarageBand and add it. And now I get this movie track here. It's a thin little track, and it shows me little frames of what's going on here, and I get this big viewer here, and I can resize this viewer, make it any size I want. I can close the viewer. I can open it again by clicking here. And at any point in here, I can see what's happening in the video. So now I can time my music and sound effects to it. So let's start off by adding a music loop. And I'll just grab one here. We'll just do like just a simple little repeating loop. And get rid of this track here. I'm not going to use that default track that was created. I'll have that loop over it. So now I've got some music. Okay, so now I want to go and add sound effects. So I'm just going to use some sample sounds that are already included here. And let's get one here that's going to go and be exactly where the transition from the star into the mustache is. And it's kind of a confetti effect there. So I'll create an airy one. I will drag this one in here. It's a very short little effect, so I'm going to increase the size so I can see. And as I drag the timeline back and forth, I can see exactly where the transition is. So it's all the way over here. Let me shrink this a little bit. I can move this back here. I can see exactly where it is. It starts right there. So that's where I want to start the sound effect. So now when I play, I should get that sound effect right at that point. I'm going to lower the sound of the drums there and increase the sound effects there so you can hear them. So there you go. You heard it right there. So that's great. So let's look at the next one here. And the next one is the change from the mustache into the balloon. And it's kind of this watery kind of thing. So I'm going to use a different one. Air pressure blast. Kind of sounds neat. And let's get it right there where it starts. And let's position the playback head here and hear it. Okay. So probably a little overkill for that. Let's do the last one. The last one is the transition from the balloon into the heart. And that's a longer effect there. So we want something a little longer. I'm going to start right around there. And we'll use sci-fi texture here. Use that. And we can put that in and adjust it right there or just at the very beginning. And we can listen to that. That goes on a little bit too long, the sound. So I'll go into mix and show automation there, and I get the line here for volume, and I will click here, command click there to create a point, and I can see exactly where this kind of ends there. So let me have it fade out to about there, command click there, and I can lower this down so it'll fade out. Let me lower this volume a bit in general. Great. Now we can raise this back up and we can see the entire thing here and watch the video as we go. So pretty simple example there, but you can imagine with real video and real things happening in the video, you put some music to it, you can put some sound effects, maybe you can match the beat up to what's going on in the video, all using the special video track here in GarageBand. And then when you're done, you can export this out, you can share it, and you can share the music back out. And this is what I like to do, share it back out as just audio, and then bring it into iMovie or Final Cut Pro or whatever it is that you're using and place it back over the video, knowing that things will be perfectly timed. In addition, if you're in a rush, you can go to File, Movie, and you can go to Export Audio to Movie. And this allows you to export to some basic settings here, and it will export it out there. And I'll save this out. And now I've got the original there, and I've also got this one which has the audio in it.